draw the front of your low back spine into your body, but still release the abdominals to breathe. We could actually stay here for 2 hours and try to figure out that equation. Spine is extending, it is curving. Front of your low back spine is engaging with the psoas so that your low back curve can open a little bit and be supported. But your abs aren't firming in so hard that you can't find a breath. So resilient outer body, work along the spine, let your low back do what it's supposed to do here. Now if you want to plant the hands by the ears or take a bridge pose, see if you can do this. I would say maybe exhale up to your full wheel to really firm in the psoas action. So plant the hands under the elbows, exhale up, lift your heels, and inhale, fill the chest. Just a little stabilization for that lumbar as you come up. Now what I talked about before was you can press your front spine in, your low ribs in, and that's gonna take your head down and back a little bit, and then maybe stretch the legs a bit straighter, but don't change anything in the spine. So you can get anything from a little wave to a big wave. Slowly tuck the tail under and the head from the psoas and come down on a block. So we're just gonna remain block or bridge or wheel 3 times. Now remember what I did with my wheel. I took the front spine in, the low ribs in, and that's gonna ripple away through the spine, through the heart, through the crown of the head. We're gonna come up again. Try on an exhale, lift the heels. Walk your feet in a little bit, so 2 fist distance. You might have to work towards that, okay? Now once you're up there, take the psoas into the body, the low ribs in, and wave that. And with all that new length, you can either walk the hands back or the feet can lengthen. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Okay, but this stays down and in because you're bending that way. You feel the difference? Body so that low back doesn't start to talk to you too.